I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you dynamics of machine. In the dynamics of machine, I am focusing to the Hartnell-Governor ball. A mass of each ball of the spring controlled by the controlled governor is, data is given, m is equal to 1.4 kg. The bell crank has a vertical arm, a is equal to 90 mm. Has to convert into meter, 0.09 meter, and horizontal B 40 mm, which has to be converted in terms of meter, 0.04 meter. The distance of fulcrum from the axis of rotation is 45 mm. Okay, fulcrum, the distance they are given it. This is the distance they are given it. Distance is given, but R is given as 45 mm. That is 45 is nothing but 0.045 meter. R is equal to 0.045 meter. If you have taken, instead of R, you have taken R1, then also no problem. You will get the same result. If the sleeve has a mass of sleeve, M is equal to 7.5 kg. The sleeve begins to rise at a 220 rpm. Now here, instead of this one, if there is a confusion, if there is a R1, then you have to take this one as a N1. Now I have taken R here, therefore I will consider here N, 220 rpm. If you have considered the R1, you have to consider N1 here. The rise of the sleeve is rise in nothing but N2, they have given it. N2 is nothing but 6%, that is 220 plus 6 divided by 100 into 220, you will get 233.2 rpm. Next, find the initial thrust. Initial thrust, that means, yes, you have to find out. That means initial thrust is nothing but this one. In this way, diagram appears in this way. Here what happened? W plus S divided by 2. W plus S2 divided by 2. You are asking the initial thrust. This is the initial thrust. Thrust, initial thrust, yes, you have to find out. This is the question mark for us. Initial thrust. And find out the stiffness of the spring. K we have to find out. Stiffness we have to find out. And this is you have to find out. Now first, I will go for formula for stiffness. Stiffness is equal to, what is the formula for stiffness? This is the list of the formula. Stiffness. 2 A by B whole square. Now, this is F2 and this is F. There is no F1 here. Now, the formula should be written in this way. F2 minus F divided by R2 minus R. You have to write in this way the formula. It has to be between average to maximum. Average to maximum. If you take the maximum to minimum, then the formula remains same. Then also the answer remains, the answer will be same here. Okay. This is the formula you have taken it from the diagram. You have written. Now here, F2. You have to find out F2 and F. What is F? F is equal to M omega square R. M is equal to omega. What is omega? 2 pi N divided by 60 whole square R. What is M? 1.4 into 2 pi. N is nothing but 220. 220 divided by 60. Whole square, R is nothing but 0.045. The answer for this one is 33.43 newton. Now find out F2. F2 is equal to M omega 2 square R, M 2 pi N2 divided by 60 whole square R2. If you have taken omega N, you have to make this one as a N1. Now 1.4 into 2 pi into N2 is nothing but 233.2 divided by 60 whole square into R. What is R? We don't know. We have to find out the value of R. the value of r, because the small r is given, you have to find out the larger r. This is unknown for us. This is unknown. R2 is unknown. R2 is unknown for us. This is unknown. Now finding the R2, what is the formula? Finding the R2, what is the formula? One more. They have given what? The rise in the speed is 8 mm. They have given the x. This is x they have given as 8 mm. X is equal to 8 mm. In terms of meter, it will be, in terms of meter, it will be 0.008 meter. Now, the formula for this finding the R, I will go for maximum minimum. X is equal to B by A, R2 minus R. R2 minus R, because it is the average and the maximum we have taken it. What is B? B is nothing but 0.04 divided by A is nothing but 0.09. R2 we don't know. R we know. R is nothing but 0.045, and x is nothing but 0.08, and the R2 will be 0.063 meter. You will obtain the value of R2 is equal to 0.63 meter. You will obtain. Next, after getting this one, substitute here in this formula. Now I will substitute here. This value I am going to substitute here. 0.063. The answer for me is nothing but 52.60 meter. Newton. It is not a meter. It is Newton. Force is there. 52.60 meter. A Newton. First you have to find out the R2. That R2 has to be substituted here. And you will get the answer. Next, after getting this one, F1 and F2, substitute here. K is equal to 2. A is nothing but 0.09. B is nothing but 0.04 divided by F2. F2 is 52.60 minus F33.43 divided by R2. R2 is 0.063 minus R 0.045. 0.045. Then you will get answer as, it is a square, you will get answer as 10783.12 Newton meter stiffness it is. After getting this value, what you have to find out? You have to find out the initial thrust. Initial thrust you have to find out. What is meant by initial thrust? Initial thrust, you can use this formula for finding the initial thrust. I will find it. This is the initial thrust. This is for maximum. This is for minimum. Initial thrust. S is equal to 2 A by B. F minus mg. Mg is not given. Consider as 0. Oh, they have given it mg. Weight they have given it. Sorry, weight they have given it. Mg they have given it. S is equal to 2. A is nothing but 0.09 divided by 0.04. F value will be 33.43 minus m. Capital M is 7.5 into 9.81. The S will be 76.9 Newton. S will be 76.9 Newton. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.